Greetings once again. Today I am in Manjaro Linux. This is version 23. It was released a couple days back. This is what it looks like when it's installed onto your system. And here is the NeoFetch for it. As you can see, the desktop environment is Plasma, and it's running its own unique Manjaro kernel at version 6.5. Now, if I go to their homepage, I'll put a link in the description. All you have to do is click on this button here. And I should note they have some ARM versions as well, 6 of them. But for me, I'm gonna get the x86 64-bit. And although I love XFCE, I decided to change it up a bit and go for the Plasma desktop this time. These are the 3 official releases, and you have 6 more community editions. So I'll just go quickly through the pre-installed software. Now, as usual, it's bundled with the KDE applications that pretty much every KDE desktop uses. For the internet, they have the Firefox web browser. For multimedia, they had VLC installed, but I had problems with it. I think maybe it has something to do with missing codecs, so I installed MPV and everything seems to work fine with this media player for me. And I also installed this GPU screen recorder tool for the purposes of recording this video here. And for Office, all it has right now is the document viewer. Now, the install process did give me the option to install LibreOffice or FreeOffice, but I chose none just to keep this setup minimal. Oh, I should note that the default file manager is Dolphin, but I installed Thunar as well because Thunar is my preferred file manager along with PCManFM. It has HTOP pre-installed. Let's take a look at that. Now it's running 1.41 gigs. It would be lower if I wasn't running this screen recorder tool. And what I really like about this install setup is it had this application for the NVIDIA driver. Everything was installed out of the box. It didn't even prompt me for anything. And from here, you can see it's running the latest NVIDIA version 535.104. So that's fantastic. Makes it very easy for me. As for some system settings, it does have time shift as your backup application. And it also has this thing, I don't know how to pronounce it, Yaquake, but it's a separate terminal and it's a drop down terminal. Let's try that again. Where is it? There we go. So that's handy. So this is another application alongside your usual terminal, which is the KDE one called Console. And to disable this drop-down terminal, you would hit F12. As for utilities, you have your usual utilities. It comes with Spectacle Screenshot, which is my default screenshot tool. And that's about all you have here. Now, if we go to software, you can see it's running PaMoC, which I think is the most user-friendly installer made for Arch. And for me, I'm gonna go to Preferences, enter my password. And I would recommend going here to the third-party section and enabling Flatpak support. It was disabled by default. Now here you also have the option to enable packages from the Arch user repository. But for Manjaro, I actually don't recommend that. I prefer to use Flatpaks instead because just because of the nature of Manjaro, its packages are a little bit behind the mainline Arch repository. But the drawback of that is if you install too many AUR apps, they might be out of sync with the mainline Arch repository apps, and some of your apps might break. So that's why I recommend Flatpaks. And to be honest, most of the apps you're going to need are in the mainline repository anyways. For me, I only install one application from Flatpak, and that's this tool here that I'm using to record the video with. So as a demonstration, we'll just install Audacity, which is an app that I usually install. All I have to do is search for it. You can see it has a Flatpak version as well, but I'm going to choose the default version. Once you hit apply, it should start installing. So here I have the option to install documentation. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to keep going and hit apply once again. And there we go. It should be installed. Here, now once it's installed, you have this trash can icon, which gives you the option to delete it. I'm going to click it here and see what happens. So, okay, it'll give you the description and you can actually launch it from here too. That didn't take that long at all to launch. And let's just exit that. That was just a demonstration. One thing I should note that I find a nice touch is this volume icon right here. So I'll just demonstrate. Usually you have your microphone set up at around 100%, and for me that's a little low, as you can tell here, and I have to use the Pulse Audio volume control to go above that 100% mark for my audio to sound proper. But that's a nice touch that I can do it right from here. So I like that feature a lot. Even though it's a small feature, it's very handy for me. I forgot to mention one app here, and that's their kernel switcher. So if you go to settings, Manjaro Settings Manager, you have the option here to switch out between different kernels. For example, I would probably prefer this LTS version since it'll work with my hardware, because I actually don't need the latest and greatest kernel. As long as the LTS version supports everything I need, I'd rather have a stable kernel that runs with reliability. So if we go to the DistroWatch homepage, we can see that Manjaro is sitting at number 5. And so out of the Arch-based distributions, it's the second most popular, the most popular one being EndeavorOS. Now, Manjaro brings a bit of nostalgia to me because it was basically the first full-blown distro that I tried. And before, I was using Puppy Linux, actually, and Puppy Linux was a great fit for me back then because I had an older computer and it just basically made my computer fly. It was much better than XP or Windows 7 or anything else that Microsoft could offer me at the time. And after using it for some time, I did try Linux Mint on that old computer, but I just found that Puppy Linux ran much better. Even though Linux Mint looked a lot nicer, I chose functionality over looks, and I spent quite a bit of time not distro hopping, but hopping between different versions of Puppy Linux. So Puppy Linux has a very robust system, and if you go to their forums, they have a whole bunch of not only mainline puppies. Right now they have a bunch of mainline puppies, not just one. They also have what they call derivatives, which are basically community-based versions of Puppy Linux. So I switched back and forth and tried a whole bunch of them before I just basically learned to customize and made it look the way I wanted myself. But I'm kind of going off in a tangent here. This is not about Puppy Linux. This is about Manjaro. So my final thoughts on Manjaro are, it's basically the same as I thought about it many years ago. And what I think of it now is it's a great Arch-based distro for beginners. It's a just works distro. It looks very nice out of the box. The developers customized everything for you. And back then, that's what I wanted. I didn't want to spend endless hours customizing. And when I installed Manjaro, it looked fantastic. And I just used it as my daily driver. And I was very happy with it for well over 2 years. Until one day it crashed on me. And that is the nature of rolling release distros. But I wasn't very good at fixing things in Linux back then, so I just jumped to another distro. It was actually Antergos at the time. And after that died out, basically the developers of Antergos basically just stopped working on it. And so after some time on Antergos, I tried Manjaro again, and after I tried it, it worked again. So I used it for about another year, and then there was another crash. After that crash, I started my journey of distro hopping. And so in the last, I would say, year or so, I distro hopped more than I did in my entire previous years of Linux. And I started using Linux for, I think, if I remember correctly, my son was around 2 years old. So it was about 13 years ago I started, but I actually never distro hopped that much. And I distro hopped so much in the last year or so that I decided to start my own channel, which is how we got here today. But anyways, I'm kind of rambling. That was a brief overview of Manjaro Linux. It looks fantastic. Maybe I'll go through the wallpapers. I don't think they have a lot of custom wallpapers. They just have a bunch of KDE wallpapers, but they do look very nice, as you can see here. But I'm going to leave it at this one. This one looks nice out of the box. So yeah, if you want a JustWorks distro based on Arch so that you can run your latest bleeding edge hardware along with the latest and greatest software, this is on my recommended list. But I think I'm gonna close this video out for today. So until next time, take care, everybody.